Make ensure that you are dropping your roll numbers in the chat box. All those students who have joined, please make ensure that you are dropping your roll numbers on the chat box in order to consider your attendance. And I will consolidate, and we will I will validate with the roll numbers with which you are dropping, and final attendance will be posted. So also note that the attendance will be considered as a regular attendance. So all all the students make ensure that you are taking this these classes with a with a good amount of seriousness. Okay. Now in today's class, always please be interactive. Let me interrupt or let me pinpoint to some of the students whether they have joined, because I could see there are regularly absent. 147, is he present? No, present. 154, present. Balaji, how are you? Are you present?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. 157, 157, still absent. 157. 164. Yeah, you are present. Yeah, I could. I hope you don't have any networking issues there. Maybe you can use the chat box.
Use the chat box.
Okay, sir.
123 again.
123.
Sorry, sir.
Okay, no problem. 164, I think Chanchala. Okay, fine. We have spent enough time. 169. Okay. So in today's class, let us start the implementation aspects of stacks. Okay, so for those students who have missed out yesterday's class, I think almost all the students are present. But let me again reiterate some of the basic fundamentals of this data structure, which is stack. Okay, so what is the definition of a stack? Stack is defined as the segment of memory which is specially located in the data memory. Okay, and the data structure is implemented in such a way that the last entity whichever has came in needs to be fetched back, which is same as last in, first out. So this is called as stack, and the usage of stack is explicitly found in mainly the three cases. Okay, so let me again repeat, what is the definition of stack means? Last in, first out. But which memory? It is in RAM. RAM meaning data memory. Okay, so why do you need stack? Stack is required for three reasons. Reason number one, whenever your application is making a function call, and if that function call, it could be either because of the system built-in function call, where the inner implementation or the inner code of that function, neither you nor we have discussed in the class. Instead, those functions are available as a pre-compiled library functions. Okay. So whenever your application is invoking those functions, right? So there is a need of making a context switch from the instruction, whatever it is executing, to some another address of your program memory, that is ROM. Okay, so because in order to make a safe context switch, and once the job which needs to be done at that address is completed, it has to return back safely. So the return address, which is the address of the next instruction, will be pushed into the top of the stack. So this is reason number one. Now in this case, we have to push the address. Okay. Now second reason is whenever your program is dealing with larger expressions. So when program is dealing with larger expressions with different operators. Okay, so compiler uses the so-called precedence of operators. So intermediate results, which are nothing but now in this case are the values, not the addresses, needs to be saved or needs to be preserved. Okay. So when you are using larger, lengthier expressions, then intermediate results, which are nothing but values, needs to be pushed. And for this purpose, you use stack, which is the second reason. And there is a third reason. The third reason is, for every microprocessor, the processor is designed in order to understand its external stimuli, which are nothing but interrupts. Okay, for example, if there is a button which is connected to the processor, and if that button is pressed by the user at any time, there could be a application where something needs to be done. Okay, so the processor already knows what are the external prone interrupts, and if you enable those interrupts, the addresses from where the programs which are corresponding to those interrupts needs to be executed, and those programs are called as interrupt service routines. Now, beyond this, at this stage or at this point, is not necessary, because it comes under writing efficient assembly logic, which will be dealt as a separate exclusive course when you deal with the microprocessor and controller architectures. Okay, so these are the three reasons wherein you have to use the data structure which is called as a stack. Okay, so with this background, now our next point is, there are three options. There are three options which are available for us to implement. What is the first option? First option is freezing the stack size with the fixed number of elements, which is nothing but a static array. Second is keeping your stack with a dynamic size. That means maintaining a stack at runtime. Then third is maintaining your stack by using a singly linked list. Okay, so having said this, stack with a singly linked list with the template, stack with the dynamic array with the template, singly linked list with the template also can be asked. Okay, so these are the six possibilities of stack. Similarly, we have to also explore when we discuss the other data structure, which is called as a queue. Okay, and coming to the operations of stack, there are four operations. One is push. Push is nothing but inserting or keeping a data item onto the top of the stack. Okay, so pop means you have to retrieve the data item again from the top of the stack. Peek means check whether the stack is empty, or if it is not empty, read the value without deleting the item. And fourth is displaying the elements of the stack. Okay. So can somebody come in? Am I audible? Are you following? At this point of time, you have anybody has any doubts? Please come in.
No, sir.
Okay. So also note that when you use the implementation of stack with either the scalable array or with a static array, you need to mandatorily use a stack pointer index or the stack index, which is called as a top. Okay, so in today's class, let us start implementing C++ stack class with 1D static array. Okay, so what I'll do is, let me start sharing the web page. Let me start sharing the content, which is a web page. So is the web page is visible?
Yes, sir. Okay.
Before we further proceed, can somebody tell some reasons why are we implementing the data structure which is a stack in C++? See, as far as stack is concerned, microprocessor needs to have a stack. Processor already know that it has a system stack. Now the point is, why are we studying? Can you justify technically, why are you studying the importance of stack? Why are you studying the implementation of stack, and that too in C++? Did you understood my question, what I'm asking? We are already coding on top of microprocessor. Processor already has probably 4 GB or 2 GB RAM. If you consider laptop, you have 4 GB of RAM. So processor already has its internal system stack. But now what is the reason that you feel are the technical reasons for implementing a stack with a fixed size array or with a scalable array or with a linked list? Yes, anybody? Did you understood my question at least? Did you understood my question at least? Somebody respond. Audible. No response.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Memory constraints. I think some of you are putting their chat box. Okay. Memory constraints. I'm talking about desktop. You have a computer, and there is no memory. There is no memory constraint because you have 4 GB of RAM. You have 1 TB or probably 500 GB of hard disk. So, which memory constraints you are talking about? The point what I'm asking, or the question what I'm asking here is, what is the reason that you think are the technical issues because of which you are studying implementation of C++ stacks or stacks which are being implemented using C++? Anybody else?
To store in a memory holes.
Why are we studying?
In stack we have only small amount of memory, sir. So we should not waste any memory.
Okay, so okay, partly yes. One more point is what probably you do is, see, we all use computers, we all use cell phones. Okay, so just after this class, okay, log in into Google and then just check what is the size of the stack in the laptop and what is the size of the stack in your so-called Samsung phone or Motorola phone. Okay, so let me highlight the technical reason. I'm now answering the question what I have raised. Let me again reiterate the question what I have asked. The question is, we are working or we are coding on top of x86 machine. What is x86? 8086. What is 8086? Fundamental microprocessor on top of which world's any computer or world's any processor is designed. Okay. And that is how many bit capacity? 16-bit microprocessor. Now we are dealing with sophisticated ICs which are with 32-bit and even 64-bit data bus with the dual cores. Okay, so the point here is different core electronic IC manufacturing companies manufactures chips with different processor designs. Okay, so when there is a need to cut down the cost, there is a need for the hardware developers to remove the unnecessary hardware blocks which are mainly designed for a generic purpose computer or a general purpose microprocessor. Okay, so when companies do when companies does that, then there is a need to rewrap the entire organization of stack as well as heap. Okay, now this is C++, because it is the rich set of object level object oriented programming without additional framework, which is again I am re-emphasizing as one of the important advantage, that there is no other platform by using which you will be coupling these data structures, that includes design of stacks, not only stacks, even the design of operating systems. For example, Android, if you see the entire kernel code, it is typically coded in C. Okay, and some routines are even coded in C++. So therefore, this is the reason why we have to look and we have to understand the careful study of implementation of both stacks and queues. Of course, the reason for queues, I will again reiterate when we discuss about queues in the upcoming classes. But as of now, in simple words, we have to understand implementation of stack using C++ routines so that the developers can able to migrate to any newly customized hardware. Okay, so this is the main reason. So what we are going to do is we are going to create a C++ class with a static array, which is option one, assuming that you are actually designing a stack for a microprocessor where you don't have a stack. That means you are giving a executable which you are asking that executable to treat as if it is a stack. Okay, so this is what we are doing in today's class. So we will do two things. We will implement option one as well as option two. So first is, what is the C++ implementation of stack class? So let us do C++ stack class implementation with a fixed size integer array. So after that, we will reuse the same code and then we will introduce the scalable array. That means instead of a fixed size array, let us give the scaling factor, which is n, and user will freeze the value of n, and that many number of elements user is willing to maintain as the stack size. Okay. So is the reasoning what I have explained is clear? So can somebody please acknowledge? And did I started sharing this C++?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So IO stream, then using. What is using? Using. What is this using? Yes, anybody? Please, what is that?
Sir, you shared this. You didn't share that CPP.
Okay.
And share the web page, is it?
Yes, sir, I shared it.
No, I have shared.
It's okay now, sir. It's okay now, sir.
Is it coming? Is it coming?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. What is using? I'm just highlighting it. What is using? Notice that using is a directive. What is a directive? Hash include. Using is also is a directive. So we will discuss some of these miscellaneous concepts at the end of the syllabus, like what is a namespace, what is using, okay, and other left out bits and pieces here and there, whichever we have left out, we will discuss at the end of the syllabus. Okay. So let us start implementing the C++ stack class with the fixed size integer. So please notice that it is almost among stacks and queues, you will get one long answer question in stack or implementation of queue, and definitely one short answer question again in stack and queues. So only in external examinations you will get around 16% of marks. Okay, so one long answer question, one full long answer question will be based on stack, and one short answer question will be based on stack and R queues. So this is very simple. The thing is, you have to be very careful when you deal with the indices. So private, public, then you need to write int, let us say main of void. Okay, so let me check whether the environment is ready. Okay, so this is the implementation of stack with size. Right. So what are the elements of stack? One is, you need to maintain the stack itself, that is S of max. Now let us hash define max, let us say 10. So I'm creating a stack size with a fixed size of stack with a size of 10 elements. Okay. Then what extra thing do I need to maintain in stack? Maintaining the top index. please note that your own other definitions is accepted. That means you have to mandatorily use a top index, which is pointing to the top of the stack. Okay, so now coming to the member functions, this is your default constructor. Then you need to probably push. Okay, so what has to be pushed is the data item, that is int, and you will be returning whether the push is successful, meaning 1, or the push is fail, meaning it is 0. Next, again int, pop. Popping is successful or popping is failed. You don't have to pass anything, so it is void, but the return type is int. Okay, so also notice that if stack is full, that means you are now creating a stack with a stack size of 10 elements. Let us assume that you are trying to push 11th element. Then you have to get an error. You have to display an error message that is called as stack overflow error. Okay. On the other hand, if stack is empty, that means there are no elements. If you are trying to retrieve the data element, then what you are getting is stack underflow error. These are the two technical terms that you need to remember. So if any attempt is made to push the data item or to push an item onto the top of the stack when stack is full, then that error which is caused at runtime is called as overflow error, because adequate stack space is not available. On the other hand, if stack is empty, if any attempt is made in order to pop, because there are no items inside the stack, okay, so if you try to pop, then you will get underflow error. Am I clear? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so next is peak is nothing but returning the top element without deleting. That means this is same as push, where we are returning and we are not deleting the top element. We are not deleting the top element. Okay. Okay. Now let us also write the destructor. For that I need to also display of void. The editor is visible.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Right. So what we will do is we will put in a infinite loop, endless loop, with the following options. What are the options? Cout to press 1 for pushing, then press 2 for popping, press 3 for displaying, no, press 3 for peaking, press 4 for display, and press 5 for exit. Since there are no extra options, I'm writing everything in one line. Now what? Read the choice. Now let us declare that as int choice. Okay. Now you are dealing about stack class, so you have to create an object. So let us say this is stack S1. Now this is an object of stack class. Let me check the list of participants. There are 57 participants. Good. I request all those students who have joined, and if at all you have not your roll numbers. Please drop your roll numbers. 126 is absent. Then 126 is absent and 147 is absent. Okay, these two are absent. Yes. Okay. Am I audible? Please respond.
Sir.
Okay, so accept choice. Now what? Switch of choice. So inside this, you will get 5 cases. And if user is pressing any other case, I mean any other value, then you say that this is invalid option. Let him do you break so that let him again see the same message of push, pop and peek as well as display and exit. Now let us keep all breaks. This is almost more than around 100 times plus asked long answer question for external exams. Implement a C++ stack class with its appropriate member functions. That's it. That means take static array, take the messages and then iterate the one whatever we are discussing today. Okay. So in option one, this is where you are. You are pushing the data item because you have to push. So but before that, you have already created an object. Now let us start writing the constructor. So what is the constructor? It is stack, is of stack of void. Okay. Now you can say that I am in default constructor. Now what? You have to point top as -1 and for int I is equal to 0, I is less than max -1, plus, you need to flush the entire contents of stack with the 0. Okay, so this is the default constructor. Clear? Let us also write for syntax's sake, what is the default destructor? Stack of void. So let us simply write a message saying that I'm in default destructor. Okay.
Top equal to -1.
Yeah, why top is equal to -1? You know that the array index is it has to start from 0. Okay, so here I want to re-emphasize a point that different authors starts the stack at different indices. Example, if you take top is equal to 0, the logic will be different. If you take top is equal to 1, the logic could be different. And if you take top is equal to -1, the logic what I am discussing is the one. Okay. So why top is equal to -1? Let us pay a little attention here. So assume that what are you doing is you are having a stack. So this is your stack. So assume that this is your stack. Okay. So you already have created total how many elements? 10 elements. This is 1, this is 2 and so on. Okay. Is it visible? What I'm annotating is visible? And so on.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So likewise, you have some 10 elements. Okay, so now this is, so this is stack s of zero in our case. Okay, so this means zero is nothing but my element. Okay, so that is the reason why I am maintaining a index I'm maintaining a index initially which is pointing to minus 1. That means this is minus 1. So what I'm doing is I'm writing minus 1 here. So top is equal to minus 1. When I do this, so if you are pushing, so what do you mean by pushing? That means if you are pushing a data item inside this, okay, so what will be done is you increment top plus plus first. Okay, so that time what will happen? So what will happen is in push, the data item, let us say int k, if you have adequate space, then you have to increment top plus plus. After incrementing top plus plus, then in s of top, you can keep k. So our coding will become very simple. This provided stack is, stack space is exists. If stack space is okay, then you increment top plus plus and then you keep s of top. So for example, when stack is empty, what was top? Minus 1. Now when you are, let us say, when you are pushing 5, item 5, then top plus plus will become 0. So what is s of top? S of 0. In s of 0, you are keeping 5. That means you are keeping 5 here. Then are you following?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so and then once you kept 5 here, now top is pointing to, this pointer is now pointing to here. Why? Because top is pointing to 0. Okay, clear?
Yes, sir.
That is the reason why I took top is equal to minus 1. So,
sir, I less than max minus 1, sir.
That is also true because max is 10. So I have memory starting from I is equal to 0 to 9. Is less than max only, right?
Yes, sir, not max.
Yeah, max only. That is correct. I is less than max only. That is correct. Okay. Good. Next. Now let us start pushing. That means C out. Enter the element to be pushed. Okay. Yes, any doubts? Now C in, let us accept that as X. So let me take another variable X. So what I'll do is s1 dot push of X. If this is returning 1, then I'll say that element is pushed. Then I'll say that C out, the element is pushed. Okay. Else what? The push operation is failed. Probably you are getting a stack overflow error. So now let us start implementing push. It has to return an integer. It has to return an integer and it has to take the element. So let us start writing the push member function. Return type is int. It is a stack it is in stack. Member function is push. It has to take int, let us say n. Okay. Or maybe let us say some element k. Right. So what is the first condition I have to do? I have to make ensure that if top is double equal to max minus 1. So up to 9, I can accept. So if top is double equal to max minus 1, then what I have to do? I have to tell that stack overflow. Stack overflow error. Okay. And then I'll return probably a error code EC, which I'll also hash define as error code EC as.
Sir, there is a lag when you're typing, sir.
There is a
lag, sir.
I'm not getting. There is what?
Lag, sir, when you're typing. Sir. Lagging it is.
Video is lagging, sir.
Yes, sir.
Oh. Now, what are you looking at?
Line number 27.
Now it is correct.
Yeah, line number 27. Okay, maybe I think I have stopped annotating. Yeah, I have stopped it. Okay, so if top is double equal to max minus 1, then there is a stack overflow error. Or to be precise, if it is greater than or equal to max minus 1, did you got greater than there in your screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so if it is greater than or equal to max minus 1, then stack overflow error, and you return error code. So let us write the error code as minus 1. So I'm just indicating that minus 1 is not the data. It is not the data. It is the error code. Is the error code which is used to communicate from member function to main. Okay. Are you following?
Are you, sir, we can input when top equal to 9, no, sir.
You can input
when top equal to 9 max minus 1, then it must be top greater than equal to greater than only max minus 1, no, sir.
Yeah, is this top is greater than or equal to max? Max is 10. 1 minute. Top is, see, once you have kept the first item, top will become 0. Ninth item, top will become 10. Okay, so when top is 9, can I keep? Top is 9, how can you keep?
We have taken stack to 10, no, sir. So at the 10th point also we can keep the value.
But indexing, you are starting from 0, right? Indexing, you are starting from 0 because you are starting from minus 1. So that means in S of 0 is nothing but first element. So when top is 0, you kept first element. When top is 9, you kept
10th element.
10th element. So when top is 9, you cannot further push. When top is 9, you cannot further push. So greater than or equal to only is correct.
Okay.
So now what? You will come here only if you have adequate space. Now you have to increment first top. Okay. And then you have to keep in S of top. Okay. And then you need to return 1. Here. Yes, sir, no?
Yes, sir.
So here you can probably say pushed. Element is pushed. That's it. So always please remember, in the implementations of stacks and queues, specifically in stacks and queues, you should not write the loops in member functions. There is no loop here. See here, there is no loop. you are assuming that there is a segment of memory and you are implementing that segment of memory as a stack. So you have to move the array index, array indices to the appropriate places in order to fetch whatever you want. Okay. So this is about push. Now let us go back to main and then let us start writing popping. Okay, so in popping, you need to retrieve the data. That means x is equal to s1 dot pop off. Okay. So then you display the popped item, popped value of x is equal to, which is let us start implementing pop. What is the return type? It is again int stack. Okay, now it is pop, no argument, void. Now stack underflow will happen if pop is less than or equal to minus 1. Pop is minus 1, then that means stack is empty, isn't it? So in this case, see out, are you getting the same text what I'm typing? I'm typing see out stack underflow now. Now I'm typing stack.
Yes, sir.
CK stack.
Yes, sir.
Underflow. Underflow error. Okay. Stack underflow error. And then here also I'll return the error code. So this will return error code, which is minus 1. Now once this return minus 1, I'll be printing in popped as minus 1, where minus 1 is not the data. It is a signal. Okay. Now I'll come to down only if popping is possible. That means I have to take answer, which is nothing but S of top, which is being pointed by the top of the stack. And then I have to decrement to top minus minus. Then I need to return answer. Okay, so this is pop. Here, whatever is the item, that item will be returned into X, and that X is caught here, and you are displaying in main. Now, what is third? Third is peaking. This is nothing but you need to check whether you have something in the stack. You don't have to delete the element. So see out, you can say peaked item is equal to, directly you can return s1 dot peak off. Okay, so now what we will do is we will implement peak member function, which is a sort of simple member function which will return whatever is being pointed by top. So it is going to return end, it is in stack, and you are talking about peak of void. So what it does is if top is double equal to or less than or equal to, top is less than or equal to minus 1, then we will return error code. We will return error code, else we will return s of top, which is being pointed. Okay, clear. Somebody respond.
Yes sir.
Writing case 4, which is display code. Now see out. Displaying the contents of the stack. Okay, so s1 dot play off. Okay, so let us start displaying the contents. We will start writing just before the destruct, just above the destructor. It is void, it is in stack. is display. Display, did I wrote the correct member function? Display, yes. Okay, and it is accepting void. Then what are you supposed to display? If top is less than or equal to minus 1, then stack is empty. See out, stack is empty. Double quotation. Okay, stack is empty. It is less than or equal to minus 1. Else, if top is greater than or equal to max minus 1, then we are displaying a message saying that stack is full. See out, stack is full. Okay. So in both the cases we will return simply, because in second case we will not return. In the first case we will return. In the second case we will not return, because in the second case we have to display the elements even if the stack is full. Okay. So else you can say that the elements in the stack are, so maybe you can cut down the cout statements which you have written in displaying the contents the stack. Okay, fine, let it be there. So in s1.display you will be displaying this, the elements in the stack are. So after this, now you have to start a for loop starting from I is equal to 0 till I is less than top. Less than or less than or equal to, less than top or less than or equal to top, which is correct. Less than or less than or equal to, less than or equal to. Top is one, if top is 0, then there is an element. That means you have to display S of 0. So you have to keep equal to. C out, S of I / T. Okay. And then that's it. This is the display part. Somebody coming? Are you?
Sir, int I.
Yeah, we'll declare that. We'll declare int I is equal to 0. Okay. Here, displaying is done. Now 5 is terminating, meaning now he wants to stop the execution process. So say have a good day. Okay, and then return 1. This is returning from main. So 1, 2, 3. Is the end of main. This is end of switch case. This is end of while. This is end of main. End of main, it has to return int. So if I come down here, I will return 0, false process. Whereas if I am returning, if I am here, then I will return true. This is a true process. Okay. So this is the implementation of stack class with the fixed size integer array. So let us compile this. Can I compile? Can somebody acknowledge?
Sir.
What has happened?
Language, sir. C++.
Come again.
C++
line. Oh, C++, I didn't select it, right? That is correct. Okay, there are some errors. What is that? S1.display. There is some missing semicolon, line number 107, just above this NDL semicolon. Fine. Okay, so default constructor. You are implementing, let us implement push. Okay. Okay, so I'm pushing the elements of let us say 10, 20 and so on. Okay, so I push to 10. So this is pushed successfully. Let us display 4, displaying the contents of the stack. Contents of the stack are here, you are getting 10, and then after this probably I have to give backslash n. Okay, so that is not coming, backslash n is not coming, so 10 is getting displayed. Okay, and next again let me push 20, display 10, 20. Let me again push. Let me push 30. Now again, let me display 20, 30. Now let me pop. I have to pop 30. So popped value is 30. Now if I display, I have to get only 10, 20. So that means if I display 4, get 10, 20. Okay. But if I now do peaking, which is 3, then I have to get 20, but I should not be deleting. So I pressed 3. Peaked item is 20, and if I again display, I should get again 10 and 20 only. Okay, now let me test the underflow case. Let me am I audible? Can somebody respond?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Again, let me again recompile this. Okay, so did I took what is the size of the stack I have taken? 10. Okay. So 1, 10, 120, 130, 150, 160, 170, 180, 190, and then display is 4. And let me also push one more fellow, 110, 100. Now again let me display, which is 4. 200 we have displayed. Now let me try to push one more thing. So if I type, let us say 200, I have to get stack overflow error. Okay, so pop it is 100, display, pop display. Now I'm going reverse, 200 24, pop it is 90, now display is back 2 4 70. Okay, next 2 4 60 2 4 40 2 4 30 2 4 20 2 4 10. Now I'm trying to pop, I'll get again 10. Now if I display, I'll get stack is empty. Then again if I try to pop, I'll get stack underflow, popped value is -1. Okay. So this is a simple implementation, but this is very important because some of the mistakes which are done by the students is not appropriately keeping the indices. Not appropriately keeping the indices. Okay, meaning you initialize top with 0, then your logic has to be correct. That is one. Second is when you do push and when you do pop, instead of concentrating on the index, writing a loop here, then saying that even we are getting the same output. Here, getting the output is not the constraint. Here, whether you have understood the data structure and get a control by using the index to fetch or to add the data element into the place of push or into the place of pop, that is what we are expecting. Okay, so
why we should not use for loops?
You should not use loops here in push and in pop. You should not use loops because it is a data structure where it is clearly defined that you have to point the top of the stack, and you will justify the reason of why we are using a pointer which is pointing to the top of the stack when we implement the same stack class by using a linked list. Okay, So let me quickly take another 2 minutes. What I'll do is I'll also complete the second option of implementing this stack with dynamic array. Shall I complete?
Yes, sir.
So I'm just taking a backup of this program. Let me take that as program 1 of ecc.txt. I'm just taking a backup. I took the backup. I'm saving it. I closed it. I minimized it. Now I came back to program editor. Program editor is visible. Now this is gone. Program editor is visible. Somebody respond. Somebody respond.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so now this is the C++ implementation of stack class with dynamic array. So what has to be done is instead of max, you take int star max. Now you need one extra element, which is n. So the other things are all same. Isn't it? Now here, what you have to do is, you are in default constructor, and here you ask the user, cout, to enter the value of n. You enter the value of n. Okay. Then what? Then you have to say, s is equal to new int of n, and then here up to n, everything has to be flushed to 0. Clear? Then push is same. Instead of max, you have to write n. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Pop is same. Then pop is same. Peak is same. Peak is same. Display is, instead of max, you have to keep n. You have to keep n. Then in destructor, once you are in destructor, you need to delete off. Yes. This is the memory. Then what? This is S1. So all other logic will be same. Everything is same. Shall I compile?
Yes.
Shall I compile?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Let us compile.
Yes, sir.
So now enter n. Why is he not accepting? Okay, I'm not
seen in of
written seen. Probably I have not written C in there. Constructor, okay, enter, so C in, accept that into n, then only it is meaningful. Okay, accept n, let me create a stack with 5 elements. Now push, let me push 10, again push 20, again push 30, again push 40, again push 50. Then display. So let me again try to push with 60. I have to get stack overflow error. Okay. Then let me pop. When I'm popping, I got 50. Then every time when I'm popping, let me display. So when I'm displaying, I lost 50. Again, I'm popping. I'm displaying. Lost 40. I lost 30. I lost 20. The last 10. Now if I display, stack is empty. Now if I try to pop again, stack underflow error. Okay, so if I try to display, stack is empty. Okay, so notice that this is a very, very simple program which is been asked many times in the external exams. So with this, we are done with the implementation of stacks with arrays which are with which are with the static arrays and as well as with dynamic arrays. So in the next class we will add a template class, or probably will take up the implementation of stack with singly linked list. Okay, any doubts? Am I audible? Any doubt?
Yes, sir. No, sir.
Okay.
No, sir.
Okay. So there are a couple of announcements from our side. One is some of the students have missed out quiz 2. So I spoke to the other class. They said they are okay with Monday. So I need a confirmation from your class also to conduct the same quiz 2 for those students who have missed out, because this is a first time online opportunity. I mean, this is the first time online platform, and because of networking issues or so, some majority of the students, around 18 students, were unable to take up the quiz. So shall I conduct the quiz 2 on Monday evening? If anybody has any problem, you can tell me right now. Anybody has any problem? Please respond. Are you using chat box? No problem. Okay, fine. So time, the other class is comfortable with 4. If you are also okay with 4, I'll conduct at 4 to 4:10. Is that okay? Okay, fine. I want others also to respond. Fine. And it is not only for those students who are absent, and those students who are present. If you want to improve your marks or scores in quiz 2, you can also take. I'll take the highest of the two exams. Is that okay? So now notice that if some students are unable to write even on Monday because of technical connectivity issues, I will again recontact by face to face. Okay, but please don't bring into that situation, because I could see that everybody are in a position to join the online class. So I don't think this could be a problem, because now there are 57 students who are present. Did 126 has joined? 126 and 147. 147, 147 is still absent. 126 is also absent. Okay, 126 and 147. Okay. Okay, so is that okay? Fine, that is one. And second is start working on lab. We were told that we will be drafting the lab timetables also. Okay, so probably you have to start executing the programs virtually in lab, and you have to show the results to me during the time slot, which will be communicated to you soon. Okay, that is second. And there will be lab internal exam also. Okay, so I think I have taken some 10 minutes extra time. So let me stop at this point. If anybody has any doubts, you are welcome to raise now. Anybody has any doubts? Quiz syllabus is, yeah, it is the same. Same what you have written in quiz 2. Sooner, after completing this stacks as well as after completing queues, I'll communicate with quiz 3. Now notice that quiz 3, there is no reconduction, only one quiz. Okay, so we are getting the news saying that the lockdown could be getting extended up to, you know, the May 17th. So as far as colleges and institutions are concerned, there is it talks about mass gathering, so it is not going to happen. So this academic year is a solo study. Okay, so you have to study by yourself and virtually interacting with the faculty and virtually connected to your friends. Okay, so let me stop at this point, and in the next class we will revisit the implementation of stack with a singly linked list. Okay, anybody has any doubts, you can ask me now, and let me also copy this program and I'll share this after the class. Let me sign out, and if anybody has any doubts, you can come in. You can come in and you can speak, or you can use the